I've done at this point two videos on the chaos of the Linux kernel GitHub. And shortly after the second video, well, all of the PRs began getting closed. And now the newest one is 3 weeks ago. Did I cause this? I don't know, but the timing is awfully close to after the video came out. So, I do feel at least a little bit responsible for the situation that's been making the rounds that we are talking about today. So, prior to the shutdown, there was a PR made. There were many PRs made, but this is one of them that was, and the title is not being shown. Originally, this was the title: Puppy Girl Looking for a DOMGF Doesn't Seem Included in Kernel. I'm not sure why the title's been changed, but maybe what we talk about later will explain so. Now, I would not recommend searching that phrase on Twitter because you're going to get nothing but OF girls, but it did sort of go semi-viral. And let's have a read of the rest of it. Hi, maintainers. I have come across a critical bug in my life. Status, single. Expected behavior, DOMGF, preferably Linux compatible, who is okay with having a dog. Treats, walks, head pats on demand via IOCTL, boots into cuddles, not a nit. 3, which is like a, you know, cutesy face. Actual behavior, literally cannot get GF to DOM me in a T4R kernel dev way. Tried grepping for mummy in the source, only found deprecation warnings. Steps to reproduce, post thirst on LKML, wait patiently for GF to appear, mod probe DOM GF and then run D message and grep for wagging tail, still waiting, and the rest of this is just all lots of fun. Now, as a reminder, yes, obviously this is a really dumb pull request. This is not a real pull request, this is a troll pull request. As a reminder, the Linux kernel GitHub is not used for development. It hasn't been used for development basically ever. There have been some PRs like 15 years ago that did make their way partially through here, but this is not how development is being done. And because of that, there has been this trend to basically use the LKML GitHub as just a message board, as like a haha fake PR thing. And sometimes people see these and think they're real and, oh my god, how dare you waste the time of kernel maintainers. But kernel maintainers are not checking this. Kernel maintainers are not, you know, using this as a development platform. In any other context, this behavior, and yes, there's one about me, in any other context, this behavior would be absolutely terrible, and all of these people should be banned. This is the one exception where it doesn't hurt anybody. Development is done through the LKML, through the kernel bugzilla, sometimes never here. So why then am I talking about this? Well, you saw the title, you saw the thumbnail, and here is the person over on Twitter. This is Celeste, VMFunk, security researcher, nullpointerRS, OXUD2, music producer, and then blog at this right here, and this is their GitHub account. Now, this is not some, you know, LARPing security researcher like some people do. This is an actual security researcher. They have been sourced by VX Underground in the past. This is someone who is actually doing real work. Yes, they did make haha funny fake PR in the Linux kernel GitHub. But besides that, they're actually a real person doing real things. And almost a day ago, they posted this. Hello, GitHub. Why did my account get suspended? I've been using GitHub for years and have never done anything that goes against the TOS on this platform. A lot of very sensitive repos are on my account, and there is no way I can even log in to back them up. Account suspended. Access to your account has been suspended due to a violation of our terms of service. I always love when a company says, you violated our terms of service, but never actually points to the thing that you did. Like, I understand maybe not saying, oh, this is exactly why, because then people can A-B test it, but The fact that companies will ban you from their platform and not tell you the thing that you did so you can make sure you don't do it again in the future. How do I know what thing I did that was bad? And in this case, not even telling you the rule you broke, so no idea whatsoever. Now, considering this is a real person doing real work, they had a pretty good guess what it was that got them banned. There was also this message as well saying they had been suspended, and then with a generic, hey, you broke a rule. We're not going to specify the exact rule, we're just going to list out you broke our acceptable use policy, which is 12 different things. Which one? Work it out yourself. Is this decision coming from the PR on the Linux repo? I genuinely do not understand what could warrant a ban, especially since if it is because of the PR, then why am I the only person who gets suspended? I am unable to appeal as it's not letting me log in on the form. Now keep watching, there has been an update to this story. Before that though, there is one other user that has been confirmed suspended from doing this. Now the problem is there's just one other user. What about the other people? What about them? So taking this person's word at face value, looking around at some of the other things they've done, they appeared to be correct that this was the one thing that they could have possibly done that maybe violated terms of service. The main issue with that, though, is when you violate terms of service on GitHub, unless you're doing something, you know, really egregious like distributing malware, there's supposed to be a warning system. You're supposed to get a warning and then you get suspended. That didn't happen. There was just the suspension and then... Yep. Now, if this was the reason for the ban, I have two questions. Question numero uno. Question number one. Why is it happening now? Why is it happening weeks after the fact? Weeks after that PR was made, closed, and locked. So again, let me find the PR. It is in one of these tabs. Whatever. We'll just use this one right here. It was made a month ago. It was closed about a month ago as well. Why is it causing an issue now? What changed? What was done that now... it's a problem. Now, some people say, oh, bans happen in waves. Yes, that's true, but that doesn't mean that people don't just get banned when they do something wrong, right? Like, just, that's not how any platform operates. When people talk about ban waves, they're usually talking about bot ban waves, so you can't A/B test your bots. That's what they're talking about, not individual actions like this one here, where you make a PR that maybe, you know, you shouldn't be doing on the platform. Question number two. If we're applying retroactive bans and suspensions, what about the years of PRs that were opened on this repo and the years of comments that were made where people were trolling? Why was it just this one person that got suspended? That doesn't make any sense, because that wasn't even the most egregious PR. There is so much worse in here. And I'm not saying that everyone should be banned, because I don't think anyone on this repo should be banned. I think this repo should be treated as this, like, this, you know, special place on the platform where everybody knows what it is and it's just cordoned off into its own separate thing. All I'm saying is, why is there not consistency here? But when this happened, this created a very fun situation for our GitHub user here, because when you get suspended, it doesn't go and delete your public repos. It does if the public repo is the cause for the suspension, so if you're distributing malware or copyrighted material, things like that. But if it's just regular code, nothing happens there. It all stays public and that's all still fine. So you can very easily go and download those repos and you're good to go. But there are other repos that you can't download. So they had 400 repositories that were private because they've been using GitHub for a very long time. and they work on things that are sensitive that you can't just put in a public repo. So all of that content was entirely inaccessible. Now, you might say, oh, well, why don't you have backups on stuff? Why do you only have stuff on GitHub? Totally fair, and they should have had a proper backup system. But also, this is the person that works across a bunch of different computers. So they were basically using GitHub as a cloud distribution platform. They were using it like OneDrive for their code, which, assuming you're not being banned from GitHub, is a totally reasonable assumption to use Project for, to use GitHub for. But when you do get banned, well, all of a sudden, all of your private repos, well, they're strewn across all of your systems. Some of them you might have backups for, some of them you might not, some of them might have older versions, and good luck piecing all of that together, let alone the projects which maybe are still relevant, but you haven't downloaded in a while because it's an older code base or something like that. Code like that might just be entirely gone now, and even though it's still being stored on GitHub servers, you have no way to access it. And not just for this situation, but in a suspension in general, this raises the question, what, if any, responsibility does GitHub have for the handling of your private repos? Because they're not going to just delete the repos. The repos are still going to be on their servers. So should they, if they ban you, give you the chance to download all of your projects? Should they not do that like they're already doing? Is there some legal basis for either of these decisions, or are they basically just winging it because no one's really tried to legally push this and see where it goes? And the fun thing about this is GitHub support process was a bit of a mess because to access their support page, you need to log into your account. When you log into your account, it says your account suspended, please contact support, which then redirects you to the login page that you can't access because you can't log into your account because you're suspended. Great UX design, guys. Yeah. Like, why? Like, why would you design a system like that? Now, the thing is, when you live in a place like Europe, you actually have rights over your data. So there is this thing called FADP for Switzerland or GDPR for the European Union, where they have to handle your data in a certain way. They have a form that you can fill in when you're logged in, but you can't log in, and, you know, that's great. But the law doesn't care about your account status. That's not a thing that doesn't matter. They don't care about what your account status is, if you're banned or anything like that. What the law does require, that if you send a request for your information, they have to send you your information within 30 days. They don't get a choice about that. That is what they have to do. So there has been this email posted as well, explaining, hey, I can't send the request because the prompt requires me to be logged in, but I can't be logged in because my account is suspended. So I would like all of my repositories, please give them to me. You are required to do so. You don't get a choice about this. Better yet, if there is maybe some way to submit a request to get my account reinstated, that would also be good. That would be an improvement to the situation we are currently in. And when I first planned this video, this was going to be my ending point. As of about, what is it now? 45 minutes ago? 50 minutes ago? Let's see. Okay, about an hour and a half ago. Okay, whatever. There was an update. Someone at GitHub messaged me, and my account just got unlocked. According to them, there had been a few posts just recently that had got a lot of reports, and they had tried reaching out by email, but seems that it got lost somewhere, and now they once again have access to their account. However, this raises a very important question. Someone noticed a problem here. In a follow-up, they say, I'm still communicating with them and will update you if something new comes up. but it seems like the reason for the ban is more due to a massive amount of reports than a human decision. Do you mean it's possible to massively report someone in GitHub and his slash her account gets locked without human interaction in the process? Now, this is not the first company that has a system where you can spam report someone and have them removed from the platform. Let's talk Blizzard and World of Warcraft. Apparently TikTok has this problem. Twitter supposedly has this problem. I wasn't aware of that. I've never heard about the problem on Twitter, but sure, let's just say it does. It is not a unique problem. There are companies that assume big bulk of reports mean you're bad, and they don't actually look at the reports. They just assume, lot of reports came in, must be totally fine. And considering what the title of this one originally was, and that the post went viral, and there are people that don't understand what the Linux kernel GitHub is, I would not be surprised if a non-insignificant number of people reported the thread, and that is what got the person banned. Under totally normal circumstances, I would fully support someone being banned for making troll PRs across multiple repos. So if you're going to a bunch of different places and you're like, haha, I want to be funny here, I'm going to be funny here. Yeah, you should be banned from the platform. At least temporarily suspended. But if you're doing so on one repo, just a singular repo, that should be the responsibility of those repo maintainers. It shouldn't be the platform that is stepping in to ban people for a troll PR. Now, if you're distributing malware, if you're doing things, you know, there are cases, but a funny troll PR on a repo with thousands of funny troll PRs and comments, I guess it's 1,000 and then thousands of comments. Again, I think that repo should be special cased. There are situations where individuals on a single repo, I think, should be suspended. And I think a good example of that is the APNA college spam on Express.js. That is a situation where these people are not trying to contribute and they are being directed by a singular source and you know what the source is. But that's not what's happening here. This is a PR on a repo that isn't used, that is used for fake PRs for years now, and that is all. And I think GitHub massively overstepped the line by banning this person. And if it is true that the reason why they were banned was a spam report system, well, that is a problem waiting to be abused. But what do you think? Do you think this person deserved a ban? Do you think the situation made total sense? Or do you think it's dumb? Do you think it's really dumb, especially if they have a spam report system? I'd love to know. So go like the video, go subscribe, and if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Starly Barapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and yup.